ಯಾತೀತಂ ಸುರೇಶಂ ಕಲವದ ನಿರತಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವೃಂದೈಕದೇವಂ ವಂದೇ ಕಂದಾವದಾತಂ ಸರಸಿ ಜನಯನಂ ದೇವಮುರ್ವೀಶರೂಪಂ ಶಂಖೇಂದ್ವಾವಮತೀವಸುಂದರತನುಂ ಶಾರ್ದೂಲಚರ್ಮಾಂಬರಂ ಕಾಲವ್ಯಾಲಕರಾಲಭೂಷಣಧರಂ ಕಾಶಶಾಂಕಪ್ರಿಯಂ ಕಾಶೀಶಂ ಕಲಿಕಲ್ಮಷೌಘಶಮನಂ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಕಲ್ಪದ್ರುಮಂ ನೌಮೀದ್ಯಂ ಗಿರಿಜಾಪತಿಂ ಗುಣನಿಧಿಂ ಕಂದರ್ಪಹಂ ಶಂಕರಂ ಯೋ ದದಾತಿ ಸತಾಂ ಶಂಭುಃ ಕೈವಲ್ಯಮಪಿ ದುರ್ಲಭಂ ಕಲಾನಾಂ ದಂದಕೃದ್ಯೋಸೌ ನೋಚು ಮೇ ಶಂಕರ ಶಂತನು. ಏಕ ಕಹತ ಮೋಹಿ ಸಕುಚ ಅತಿ ರಹಾ ಬಾಲಿಕಿ ಕಾಂಖ ಇನ ಮಹುರಾವನ ತೈ ಕವನ ಸತ್ಯವದಹಿ ತಜಿ ಮಾಖ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಂಬರ್ 24 ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲಂಕಾ ಕಾಂಡ. ಅಂಗದ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ ವಿತ್ ರಾವಣ ಅಂದೇ ಬೋಧ ದೇಮ ರಿಯಲಿ throwing really bad words at each other, but there's a marked distinction between the two of them. While Ravan boasts about his own strength and the might of his arms, Angad is speaking about the might and power and strength and glory of Ram, and that is the difference, huh? This is the main difference. Angad is glorifying Ram, Rama's strength, Rama's power, Rama's glory, you know, Rama's mahima. And Ravan went on prattling about his own and boasting about his own strength. And so you could clearly see that is the difference between a bhakta and a non-bhakta or a rakshasa. He only speaks about himself like that. And that continues again. You'll see now after number 24. Let us see.
ಸುನು ಸಚ ಸೋಯ್ ರಾವಣ ಬಲ ಸೀಲಾಗೆ ಜಾಸು ಭುಜಸಿ ಜಾನ ಉಮಾಪತಿ ಜಾಸು ಸುರಾಯಿ ಪೂಜೆ ಉಜೈ ಸಿರ ಸುಮನ ಚಡಾಯಿ ಸಿರ ಸರೋಜ ನಿಜ ಕರನ್ಹಿ ಅಂತಾರಿ ಪೂಜೆ ಅಮಿತ ಬಾರ ತ್ರಿಪುರಾರಿ ಭುಜ ಕ್ರಮ ದಿಗಪಾಲ ಸತ ಅಜಹು ಜಿನ್ಹಕೆ ಉರಸಾಲ ಜಾನೈ ದಿಗ್ಗಜ ಉರ ಕಠಿನಾಯಿ ಜವ ಜವ ಬಿರೌ ಜಾಯಿ ವರಿಯಾಯಿ ಜಿನ್ಹಕೆ ದಸನ ಕರಾಲ ನ ಕೂಟೆ ಉರ ಲಾಗತ ಮೂಲಕ ಇವ ಟೂಟೆ ಯಾಸು ಚಲತ ದೋಲತಿ ಇಮಿ ಧರಣಿ ಚರತ ಮತ್ತ ಗಜ ಜಿಮಿ ಲಘು ತರಣಿ ಸೋಯಿ ರಾವಣ ಜಗ ಬಿದಿತ ಪ್ರತಾಪಿ ಸುನೆಹಿ ನ ಶ್ರವಣ ಅಲೀಕ ಪ್ರಲಾಪಿ ತೇ ರಾವಣ ಕಹ ಲಘು ಕಹಸಿ ನರ ಕರ ಕರ ಶಿವ ಖಾನ ರೇ ಕಪಿ ಬರ್ಬರ ಖರ್ಬಖಲ ಅವ ಜಾನಾ ತವ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಸಿಯಾವರ ರಾಮ ಚಂದ್ರ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಪವನ ಸು ಪತಿ ಮಹಾದೇವ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಬೋಲೋ ಭಾಯ ತನ ಕೀ. ಸುನು ಸಠ ಸೋಯ್ ರಾವಣ ಬಲ ಸೀಲಾ. ಅಂಗಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ನೋ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ರಾವಣ್ ಹೂ ವಾಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಇನ್
Narak, you know. In Patal, little children captured and tied him in a horse stable and beat him blue and black. And there was another Ravan who Bali kept under his arms for 6 months. Which one of those Ravan? And there was another Ravan who Sahasrabahu caught and took home as a toy. Which one of those Ravan are you? Again, tell. And then Ravan replies, no, this is this. Sunu Sat, listen, you foolish. Soi Ravan Balasila Haragiri Jan Jasu Bhuja Leela. I am that Ravan whose power is known by Kailash Parvat also. Haragiri Jan Jasu Bhuja, the might of whose arms is known even by that Kailash Parvat. Jan Umapati, that Ravan who is known by Lord Shiva, Umapati, Jasu Surai, Pujeu, whose lordliness I worship, Pujeu Jehi Siras Sumana Charai, by cutting off one head at a time of mine and offering instead of flowers. You may see, he goes on boasting about his own achievement and own. It shows a poor personality. Personality bereft of any richness. When one has to boast about one's own things. Then I cut off one of each head and offered instead of flowers to that Lord Shiva. That is the Ravan, which you are talking about, Ravan kidnapped and, I mean, captured there by little children. No. In other words, he has to counter. Sirasaroj, my lotus head, his own lotus head. How far he goes to tell my... We always say Bhagwan's lotus eyes, Bhagwan's lotus hands, you know, Bhagwan's lotus face. So we praise the Lord, using. He's in my lotus head. Sirasaroja Nija. See, Nija means mine. Karanhi Utari, with my own hands, I cut off. Then, Pujeu. Amitabhara Tripurari. Countless times I worshipped Tripurari, Lord Shiva. Look at this. Bhujabikramajanahi Digpala. It means the might of my arms is known by all the protectors of the directions. You know, Digpal, they are all called. Satya, you fool. Ajahu Jinake Ura Sala. Till now their hearts are smarting and paining from the might of my arms. Like that. Janahi Digpal Ura Katinai. And the elephants of the Digpalas are all elephants. Those elephants who protect the quarters, different quarters. Janahi Ura Katinai. They know the power and might of my chest. Jaba Jaba Bhirau Jai Bariai. Whenever I had any opportunity to fight with them, grapple with them, these elephants. What? Jinike dasana karal na phute. Means to say, their terrible tusk could not pierce my chest. Like that. Ura lagata mulaka eva tute. When their tusk hit my chest, it broke like muli. Muli, you know that horseradish, that little white radish thing. That tusk broke like muli. Muli we call it. Why? Yeah. Mulak. So he's boasting about his arms, the might of his chest, so tough that elephant's tusk break. Then, jasu chalata dolati, dolati imi dharani. That Ravan who walks, and when he walks, the earth quivers. The earth reels under his feet. Charata matta gaja jimi laghu that makes the earth shake like a little boat. Like when a wild elephant is walking on the earth, makes the earth shake. I am that Ravan, makes it shake like a little boat. Laghu tarani. Soi Ravan jaga bidita pratapi. Sunahi nashravana alika pralapi. You prattling, what do you call, chatterbox liar? He called them liar also. Chatterbox. What is a chatterbox? You haven't heard of that Ravan? In other words, he thinks Angad is lying because he hasn't heard of that Ravan and all. Swairavana jaga vidita pratapi, that most glorious Ravan known throughout the whole world, you haven't heard. Lying chatterbox like you. Tehi Ravana kaha lagu kahasi nara karak karasi bakhan. Re kapi bar bar bara kharba khala ab jana tava and you bypass this great. Hey Ravan kaha lagu kahasi, means you speak belittlingly of this Ravan, and you with so much of great accomplishments, and you glorify narakara karasi makhan, you glorify a mere man. That means Ram, who is a mere man. What has he done? This Ravan was conquered and has is so powerful. Re kapi barbara. Barbara means primitive, you know. You primitive monkey. Like that. And karva also means, you know, lame, deformed, like that. Karva. Laghu. I'm khala, you wretch. Aba jana tava gyan. Now I know how stupid you are. I know your knowledge. Because you glorify a mere man, and Ravan, who has so many accomplishments to his credit, you belittle. Now I know your knowledge. That means now I know the degree of your ignorance. I say, ab jana tava gyan, means your gyan is alpa. You are more ignorant. Ravan, suni angad sako pakah bani. Now Angad got angry. But Angad replied, now see.
Suni Angad sakop kah bani, bolu sambhari atham abhimani, sahas bahu bhuja gahana apara, dahana anal sam jasu kuthara, jasu parasu sagar khar dhara, murendra paganit bahubara, Tasu garba jai dekhat bhaga, sonar kyo das sisa abhaga, Ram manuj kasare sat banga, dhanvi kamu ganga, pasu sur dhenu kalpataru rukha, anna dana aru rasa iyusha, Vaitanya Sanan Chintamani Puni Upaladasanan Sunumati Mand Lok Vaikuntha Lab Ki Raghupati Bhagati Akuntha Sen Sahit Tava Manamati Vana Ujari Purja Re sat hanuman kapi jaya ujota vasut marisiya var ramachandra ki jay pavan sut hanuman ki jay umapati mahadev ki jay lo bhai
suni angad now listening to these words of Ravana. Sakop kahabani, with great anger now he spoke. Bolu sambhari adhama abhimani, you egoistic. Adhama means wretch, like whatever. You egoistic wretch. Be careful what you say. See a young boy, young prince, telling. Be careful what you say. Means choose your words carefully, otherwise. Doesn't say otherwise, but. Sahasrabahu, bhuja gahana apara. Sahasrabahu, a thousand. Sahasrabahu means 1,000 armed. The 1,000 armed, dahana anala sama jasu kuthara, were like a great big forest, and Rama's axe was like a fire to burn down. I mean, Rama finished that Lord finished Sahasra Bahu also. So now he's glorifying Rama again, you know, started same thing. There's so many different stories are there. You can go and see in all Puranas and all. Dahana Anala Sama Jasu Kuthara, his axe, well, means finished at Sahasra Bahu with so many arms. You only have 20 arms, you know. See, he took his axe and cut off all 1,000 arms of Sahasra Bahu. Why is he 20 arms? Rama may not even have to touch you with that axe. Only pass it near you, all your arms will fall off. Jasu pasu parasu sagar khara dhara bure nripa aganita bahu bara. It means whose Rama's axe is like parasu sagar khara dhara, like the flow of the salty ocean which has drowned many kings in the past. Who are you? In other words, his arms has, his axe is like the salty ocean. Bure nipa aganita, countless kings. Bahubara, so many times. Tasu garba jehi dekhata bhaga. Now he's speaking of Parasuram. Parasuram's garba, pride also was quelled by this Rama, and he ran away. So narakyo, that's a cease of bhaga. You, wretched person, you think he's an ordinary man? Angad, Rama Manuja. Now see all this, a whole long line of comparisons. Rama Manuja, Kasare Sata, Bhanga, you arrogant fool, foolish fellow like you. Like that. Dhanvi, you think, see now what the comparison. You are thinking Rama is a man. Ram, you're thinking to be an ordinary man. See what? Dhanvi Kamu, you think Kamadev is an ordinary archer? When Kamadev shoots that arrow, he never misses. You think Kamadev is an ordinary archer? An ordinary archer may miss. So you think like this now, you are thinking all opposite things. You think Ram is an ordinary man. You think Kamadev is an ordinary archer or what? Nadi Puni, Ganga is any ordinary Nadi, any ordinary river. So all these examples, just like you think, Rama is an ordinary man. Pasu, Suradhenu, the Kamdhenu, Suradhenu, the cow of the heavens, you think is some ordinary animal. Kalpataru, Rukha, the tree of paradise, or the, what you call, wish fulfilling tree. It's some ordinary tree or what? Annadana, giving food, is some ordinary dan. See how important in this tradition. Giving food exceeds every dan. Giving food is some ordinary dan. Like that. Aru, rasa piyusha, an amrit nectar, you think is some ordinary drink? Nectar is some ordinary drink or what? Bainateya khaga or garur. Bainateya is garur. Bainateya is pratyaya of Vinita. His mother's name was Vinita. Garur's mother. So from that, Vainateya. Like Kunti Kaunteya, like that. Anjani? Anjaneya, Vinita Vainateya, like that. But Vainateya in Avadhi becomes Vainateya. Bay, bay. Any way becomes bay. Any way, V becomes B. Like Vivek becomes Bibek. Like that. Is a Garuda some ordinary bird or what? What do you think? Ahisa Sahanan. Sahasranan means thousand-headed serpent is some ordinary snake. In all the same way you are thinking Ram is an ordinary man. Means a thousand-headed serpent on whom Bhagavan Vishnu sleeps, who is taken incarnation as Lakshmana. But as some ordinary snake or what? Or he. Chintamani Puni Upala Dasanan. Oh, ten-headed. You think that the Chintamani touchstone, philosopher's stone, you know, when they touch, it turns to gold. And that touchstone, that is some ordinary upal, some stone. Sunumati manda, you dance. What is given there? You dullard. Sunu, listen, you dullard. Loka Vaikunth. Vaikunth is some ordinary world. Vaikunth. Loka Vaikunth. Like some ordinary world or what? Lavaki Ragupati Bhagati Akuntha. I mean, getting the bhakti, devotion to Ram. You know, so many times we saw Ram granted devotion to all his devotees who he met, you know, Kevat and Shabari and all who he met coming. He granted devotion to them, supreme devotion. So getting that supreme devotion, right, that is some ordinary blessing or acquisition in this world or what? Sena Sahita. Now last one. I don't know if last one, might be more. Sena Sahita Tava Manamati. Hanuman is subject. Hanuman came there and he crushed your pride along with your whole army's pride. That Hanuman came and crushed your pride. Manamati, Bana Ujari, uprooted your whole garden, forest and everything. Then Pura Jari, burned down your whole city. Kasa Re Satha Hanuman Kapi. You foolish. Hanuman is a monkey. It's Bhagavan Shiva incarnate, isn't it? Your own guru and you don't know. He was a Bhashiva Bhakta. So he's a monkey or what? Gaya Ujo Tava Suta Mari and killed your son also. So he'll be an ordinary monkey. In other words, he's pointing out Ravan's delusion. Ravan's delusion is such that delusion, I told you, na? Delusion is seeing things upside down. That is the very simplest definition of delusion. Thinking or seeing anything other than what it is. That is called delusion. Opposite to or other than what it is. No, that means to say, delusion is only a matter of degrees in everybody. Eh? Because we see things as separate and unconnected. We see things as finite. But that is other than what it is. It is only finite from a certain standpoint. And seeing with our eyes is not any verification of truth. When we see the sun, it is that big. The moon. When we see the earth, it is flat. Isn't it? But so seeing is not any verification of truth. So delusion is only a matter of degrees. But people like to multiply their delusions. Instead of trying to come out from that delusion, instead of find oneself in satsang, find gurus, find teachers, find shastras, study Vedanta, instead of doing that, we multiply our delusion. And see how fight has gone with Ravan now. The Lord of the universe is calling you an ordinary man. Like that. Ram Manuj. So Angad is pointing out, now see, a young person had to point out this to a very aged, experienced king. What a thing. It's not like Angad is any guru or something. He belongs to the same profession, isn't it? He's a prince. He comes from the same kind of kingly family. But he can see because he's on the side of Rama. That is the difference. He's on Rama's side, so he can see clearly. And this person is opposed to Rama. So like that, he's pointing out all of these delusions that you'll consider Hanuman to be a mere monkey or what? Something has to be wrong with you only. He continues now. Sunu Ravan, Parihari Chaturai. And then he also gives good advice. Seeing that Ravan's delusion is so much, better I give you some good advice. But Ravan doesn't like the word advice, you know. He thinks advice is a vice. So now see.
सुनु रावण परिहरि चतुराय भजसिन कृपा सिंधु रघुराय जौ खल भय सि राम कर द्रोहि ब्रह्म रुद्र सकराखि न तोहि मूर वृता जनि मार सिंगाला राम बयर अस होइहि हाला तव सिर निकर कपिन के आगे परिहि धरनि राम सर लागे हे तव सिर कंदुक समनाना खेली हि वालु की स चौगाना जब ही समर को पी रघुनायक चुति हि अति कराल बहुसायक तब कि चली काल तुम्हारा अस विचारी वजु राम उदार सुनत बचन रावण पर जार जरत महानल जनु घृत पार कुंभकरण अस बंधु मम सुत प्रसिद्ध चक्रारी मोर पराक्रम नहीं सुने जिते उचराचर चारि सियावर रामचंद्र की जय वन सुत हनुमान की जय मापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई तन की
सुनो रावण परिहरि चतुराई यू ड्रॉप ऑल योर चतुराई मीन्स इन ट्रिनिडाड वी कॉल स्मार्ट मान थिंग यू नो You know, deceit and all these things, all these fraudulent, deceitful, conniving kind of ways. You drop all of these things. Chaturai, Bhajasina, Kripa Sindhu. Why don't you drop and worship that Ram? Jau khala bhayasi Ram kara drohi. Foolish, a wicked, wretched person. You. If you continue to persist in your enmity with Bhagwan Ram, Brahma Rudra Saka Rakhina Tohi. Brahmaji, Lord Shiva also will not be able to save you. And do you know, if Rama is killing you and you call out to Lord Shiva and Lord Shiva comes, he'll tell Rama, kill him faster. Because Rama and Lord Shiva are like one, isn't it? Rama loves Lord Shiva and Lord Shiva loves Rama. He'll listen to you. He'll listen to Rama. Lord Shiva will listen to Rama, not to you. You see? So, Lord Shiva cannot save you and Brahmaji also cannot save you. Moor Vritha Jani Marasi Ngala. Don't go on bragging in vain, you foolish. Mood. So many insults. Mood, khala, this, that, everything he's calling, any word that is possible. Mood, Vritha Jani Marasi Gala. Don't go on bragging and boasting in vain. Ram Bayar Asa Hoihi Hala. Hala means fate. Fate, F-A-T-E, fate. What will happen to you, I tell you, if you oppose Rama? Let me tell you now what will happen to you. Already I gave you advice, and I'm giving you now warning. Means to say, if you continue in your enmity with Rama, Bayar, asa hoihi hala, this will be your fate. What? Tavasir, your heads. Tavasir nikara kapina ke age parihahi dharani Rama sara lage. Each one of your heads will be cut off by the arrows of Rama and they will fall on the earth in front of the monkeys. The heads will fall in, on the earth in front of the monkeys. And te tavasir kanduka sama nana keli hai bhalu kisa chogana and they will play polo with your heads. Polo, you know, they beat that. They hit that ball with a polo ball. He said they will play, these monkeys, when they fall down, they'll play polo with your heads. That is the, you know, you're using Samadhana Bheda, some fear, you know, for Ravan. I don't know if it will work. Jabahi samar kopihi ragunayak chuti hai atikaral bahu. When Rama gets angry on that battlefield and his arrows start flying like that, all his numerous arrows start flying. Tab ki chali hai asa gal tumhara asa bichari bhuja Rama udara. Think like this and worship the arms. Bhaju Rama udara. Worship Rama, that most exalted Rama. Because when his arrows start flying on that battlefield, that time, tab ki chali hai asa gal tumhara, then what will happen to your vain boasting? Now you're always vain boasting, you're boasting. But when Rama's arrows start flying, sunata bachana ravana parajara, ravana flare up like a like a raging conflagration. Like a mad bull. Ravana flared up. Huh? Then jaratama hanala janu grita para, as though somebody threw fire into ghee into a raging fire. Fire already burning and somebody threw ghee in there. Ravana flared up like that. Then he shouted, Kumbhakaran asa bandhu mama. I have a brother like Kumbhakaran. Now again he's boasting. Now I forget all about his arms now. He's boasting about what he has around him now. Kumbhakaran asa bandhu mama, with a brother like Kumbhakaran and Suta Prasiddha Sakrari, and a son like Meghanath, who is the enemy of Sakra is Indra. Sakraari is Sakrari. Sakra Indra. And a son who is the enemy of Indra, who conquered the Meghanath, Indrajit. A son like that. Mor parakrama nahi sunahi jiteu charachara jhari. And myself also was conquered the whole charachara universe, means moving and unmoving universe. Mor parakrama nahi sunahi jiteu. You have not heard of me, and who has conquered all of this? Like that. Oh, means still, even if he gets angry now, right? Angry Kshatriya should start fighting. Angry Kshatriya is boasting. What is this thing? But Kshatriyas are known for boasting also. Eh? That is true. They like to boast about their muscles. Now see, Ravan continues.
Satsakha mrega jori sahai bandha sindhu ihai prabhutai nagai khala anek bari sa surna hoite sunu sab ki sa mama bhuja sagar bal jal pura jahan bure bahu sur nar sura Bisa prayodi agada apara ko asbira jo paihi para dikpalan mein nir barawa bhup sujas khal moi sunawa jau pei samar subhat thavanatha puni puni kasi jasu guna gatha Taubatit Kaja Ripusan Priti Karat Nailaja Haragiri Matan Nirakumam Bahu Punisat Kapinija Prabhu Isarahu Surakavan Ravan Sarisa Swakar Kati Jaiksisa Une anala ati harshavahu bar sakhi gauri sasiyavar ramchandra ki jai pavan sut hanuman ki jai umavati
Satasakha mriga jehi jori sahai bandha sindhu ihai prabhutai lokhe. Look how many things I have told, which are there to my credit. What is there to the credit of that Ram? He made friends with monkeys and he built a bridge over the ocean. That is what is there to his credit. Bandha sindhu ihai prabhutai. This is his greatness. He built a bridge. What greatness is that? There is no greatness. Nagi khaga anek barisa surna hoi te sunu sab kisa. So many birds fly over the ocean. Not any great veer or hero or nothing. They fly every day and nobody praised them. So he built a bridge over the ocean. What praise? What? He has also many good arguments. Of course, flawed arguments, but they sound very flowery. Ravan. Look here, I've just recounted all the things to my credit. How many things I have to my credit. What he has to his credit, he built a bridge. But what credit is that? He built a bridge to cross the ocean. Birds fly and cross for nothing. Like, one Ramakrishna Paramahamsa story I told you. One fellow went to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. What is all this spirituality and all? You don't have any powers? Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, no, I don't have any powers. What power? All these years you're sitting here in the temple and doing so many things and you don't have any powers. All the spirituality is useless. So that fellow went on the other side of Ganga, there from Dakshineshwar, and he sat in that forest for 14 years, 13 years or something. 13 years he sat in that forest doing tapas. And after 13 years he gained such power, he was able to walk on the Ganga and come back. Walk on the water. He walked on the water and came back. And he told Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, see, look, tapas for 13 years. Look, I can walk on the water. And you sitting here so all of these years doing nothing, you have no power also. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said that your 13 years of tapas is worth 2 cents. Because if you paid the boatman 2 cents, he would have brought you here. You have to go and walk on the water. 2 cents, 13 years, gone down the drain like nothing. So Ravan is using that kind of example now. What is this? He made friends with all these monkeys, built a bridge that has to his credit, but has no credit. The birds fly over here for zero, for no money, for nothing. And nobody praises them also. Oh, look, this bird fly over this ocean. Nobody praises also. Useless. That's how he twists. He's good at twisting words. Then, Mama Bhuja Sagar Bala Jala Pura. Now see, in comparison to that, my arms, it's like a great ocean, 20 of them. 20 arms, like 20 oceans. You see, Mama Bhuja Sagar Bala Jala Pura Jabure Bausura Narasura, in which my arms, like 20 oceans, in which so many great heroes and men and so many have drowned in the past. Now that is ocean, not this ocean. Like, in other words, he's boasting like that. So many great ones have beasts, apayoti, agad, apara. My 20 arms, like 20 oceans, means unfathomable. And apara means boundless, shoreless. Like that. Ko asi bir jo paihi para. Which bir, which hero, warrior, valorous fighter in this world can cross over this ocean of my arms? They'll drown. 20 of them one time. Digpalana me neer bharava. I captured all digpals and I made them bring water for me. What? I sat there and literally, you bring water. Like that. Bhupa sujasu khala mohi sunava. Bhupa sujasu khala mohi sunava. Fool like you. Kings sang my praises. Bhupa sujasu khala mohi sunava. And jaupe samar subhata tava natha. How many kings have sang my praises? And you are tava natha, you're going on talking about puni puni kasi jasu guna gatha. You're going on talking about that, your master, whoever that master is. Like that. If he, whom you talk about so much, jaupe samar subhata, If he is such a great Subhat, means warrior, the one who you went on talking so much about, tau basita patawat kehi kaja, why he sent an ambassador like you? Why, if he is such a great warrior, why didn't he come fight himself? He has to send somebody, and that too foolish person like you. He sent Ripusana Priti Karata Nahi Laja. He has no shame. He sent you to make friendship with me here. Means if he's any great warrior, he should not send you to make friendship or this or that. Come and fight. Like that. Ravana was also like, because of tamas foolish. Eh? Tamasic foolish, see, ignorance is bliss or not? Huh? Ignorance is bliss. Ignorance and tamas is one and same. So you are not afraid because of ignorance only, because of tamas. He was not afraid because of any other thing, because of tamas only. Haragiri, and again he went back now to boasting. Same thing over and over. Haragiri matana nirakumama bahu punisata kapi nija prabhui sarahu. You look at my mighty arms, which niraku, look, mama bahu, my mighty arms, which topple Kailash Parvat also, Himagiri. You're looking at it also, and now Puni Sata Nija Prabhu Sarahu, you still praising that Lord of yours, looking at my arms. This arm, same arm with topple that Kailash Parvat. Sur Kavana Ravana Sarisa Swakara Kati Jehi sees. Where is there any great hero like me who Swakara Kati Jehi sees? We cut one by one of his own head, and Hune Anala Ati Harashabahu gladly offered it in the fire for Bar Sarika, in the fire for Lord Shiva. And he himself is the witness. Bahu Bar Saki Gaurisa. Many times over, cut a head and offer it in the fire, Lord Shiva himself being the witness. You see, no, without this thing he mentioned before, and again he mentioning same thing. So like that, he go still boast. There's a lot of lying on boasting only. Tulsidaji means to say how foolish is boasting. He deals with small durgunas, which appear small, but those durgunas are great stumbling blocks, obstacles on our spiritual path. So one of them is singing one's own praises. Self-praise, they say, is no praise. Singing one's praises. We have to also be very, very, very careful about even what we call as gunas. Not only durgunas, but gunas also, we have to be careful. Sometimes a guna can also be a golden chain and an iron chain. Chain is? Chain, isn't it? Somebody, I don't remember who it was now, on the first day when we were in our camp. And these things need reflection. Camp or pizza? Yesterday maybe. Pizza we are having. So when that pizza came out, one is giving to the other one. And that other one, no, pele up. And the pele up. And the pele up, nobody was eating pizza. So that other one said, no pele up. You just take pizza and eat. Because sometimes the courtesy also can become a. I have a lot of courtesy, you know. Pele up. That also becomes a stumbling block, obstacle, you see. Then I get pride in courtesy now. I have a lot of courtesy, you know. You have first. And I take the thing and eat. You forget about it. Courtesy, there's time and place for courtesy. You have to know also, like that. So even what we call as gunas and all, we have to be very careful. All right, we'll see this coming again. So here it is a little bit related to that, is self-praise.
ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम।